But I think it's more than just the players and going onto the field. I think there's a lot to be done behind the scenes to create a professional environment. We've shown we can play good football. We've shown that we have what it takes to pull off a good performance at the World Cup. So the happy feeling, missing a lot.
Yeah, extremely disappointing. We were second best, even third best today, to be honest. We were awful. In possession, we didn't do anything.
Day one in Fort Lauderdale, we played for Gold Cup 2015. Now about to hit the pitch.
Yeah, we had a good two sessions today. Went well, you know, we've done some team shape for the game tomorrow. And yeah, everyone's looking confident, everyone looking happy, excited for the first game of the night. Yeah, I believe it's very crucial, you know, because obviously everyone needs to bond together, everyone needs to train together and be together, eat together, you know, because we're a team and we lose as a team, we win as a team. So hopefully by the time everyone, like Leicester and Cordell get here, you know, we'll be together. So it's going to be difficult, you know, because we're playing against some good sides. But, you know, if we go out there and work hard, you know, I think football comes natural to us. So if we go there and work hard and give our best shot, I think we'll be all right.
Hot boy.
So you're going to see us when you on the Charlotte leg, because that's one of the states that come under our jurisdiction. We're bringing out a lot of people from New York, from Atlanta and from North Carolina to come out and support in blocks. We have reserved a blocker tickets for our game to give you all some Trinidad and Tobago national support out here, the diaspora support.
The first half we were very compact, we defended well, we were organized, we didn't give up many chances. But when we did win the ball, our ball speed, our possession was at times too erratic. We didn't really build well and we didn't really counter well. But in the second half, it was almost completely different. We defended well, we recovered the ball, we pushed the ball forward quickly, and we got players up in numbers to support it. Things are going well. Some of the players certainly are focused and show good energy, good synergy, and I like that. Other players are still trying to find their form, but that's normal. That's normal. It could be nerves, but I think in general the team is ready to play the game.
The game for us tomorrow is most important. We have prepared well. We're looking forward to a very good match against Guatemala, and we're looking, you know, to get maximum points to give up.
So tomorrow, I'm not saying you must or you have to think about it. I am saying you are going to put on the performance in your life. And any crowd that is here will become all your crowd. And it will become all your crowd. You will put on the performance in your life. Because this stadium is accustomed to legends. It's accustomed to legends. This is a place, this is a theater that you have to put on a show.
Great first half, we were in control. Second half was a little bit, but what do you make of it?
Yeah, I thought first half we could have actually been up by five. We did good things, we pressed well, we recovered the ball well, our ball possession was good. They couldn't settle down and play. And in the second half, for some reason, we just defended too deep, didn't get pressure on the ball, allow them to move the ball and make us run a lot. And I mean, you're on the sideline screaming to try and get the players to get hold of the ball and keep it and make them do the running. And it caused us a lot of problems. To be honest, we were lucky in the second half.
I felt great, you know, coming away with the 3 points, feel great, and, you know, scoring at home, in my hometown, it feel better, you know.
definitely amazing. Being able to come out in the first game and the way the team played and, you know, being able to get a goal that just topped it off.
It had no feeling really, you know. I think the ambition was so big, you know, for the game. It was my first international goal, so of course, it's a mixed feeling because, like I say, okay, trying to not celebrate too much and also want to do so much, but it's an amazing feeling.
3 points on the board, and the team delivered what coach Stephen Hart asked of them the day before the match, to put down the performance of their lives at Soldier Field. It was the most convincing victory by a Trinidad and Tobago team over a Central American opponent at the Gold Cup, aside from the 4-2 win in 2000 by a team that included the likes of Dwight York, Russell Latipi and David Nakin. Meantime, back in Port of Spain, TTFA President Raymond Timkey was ecstatic about the win.
My action is one of ecstasy. I feel so very pleased that in our first game we could have performed that well. It gives every reason why we should be excited and enthused about what is due to come in the future. They have set a standard and level of performance and intensity that could only, you know, give us all the wins we are looking for and take Trinidad to be where ready we would like to be as we proceed with the other games.
Right, and then when you catch yourself, you're back into the game again. Good? Almost as if I played with Buku, I would say, hey, Andre, I need something. You're in, I have you covered. This is an example. And we will get it right. We will get it right. The difficulty is we don't have any training today with the team. And then tomorrow we have one session and then we have to go into our game. Right? The good thing is we know we can do it. We know we can do it. It's just a matter of putting two halves together. Right? That's a credit to you guys. Credit to you guys. Great support from off the bench. Good. We know as a team what we need. We have our focus. Do not stray from our focus. We have not achieved anything. We win one game. Right? We haven't achieved anything. Good. One gone. Next one to go. And we deal with that. Fair enough?